in my today's class of subject class on subject structural analysis under the topic of anchors, cable and tower. This is tutorial class and we will solve few questions based on that. So, the first question is, a flexible suspension cable 160 meter span and 16 meter central dip carries a UDL carries a load of 1/2 kN per lineal horizontal meter. Okay, means we have a cable. Okay, we have a cable which has supports A and B at L is equal to how much distance? L is equal to 160 meter. Okay, and the both level are at the same. Both level are at same elevation. Okay. Calculate the maximum and minimum tension in the cable. We need to, and load is given to us UDL. Okay, UDL. So W of W UDL is how much? 1/2 means 0.5 kN per meter. This is the value of W. D value is given to us. This value is 16 meter. This is 16 meter. Okay, so maximum and minimum. Maximum and minimum tension. Maximum tension. Yeah, first of all, minimum tension. T minimum. T minimum and T max. Okay. What are T minimum and T max? T max, I told you in previous class that at point A, support reaction V A and horizontal thrust H, and at point B, horizontal thrust and this one is vertical reaction V B. Okay. At these two points A and B, at these two points, tension in the cable will be maximum. Tension in the cable will be maximum, and that value is either V A square plus V A square or V B square plus H square. Why V A or V B? Because both value will be same due to the symmetry. So, the maximum value is this, and the minimum value will be, minimum value is at here, minimum value is at this point. Okay, suppose this point is C. Okay, minimum value. And what will be the value? What will be the value? If you will plot the FBD, okay, at this point, then what we will have? You will have V A and H, here load, UDL load. Okay, here this one and this one type of. Okay, so this will be the tension tension in the cable at point C. Okay, this is a tangent. This is a tangent. This T, this one, this will be the value of the tension at point C. At point C, so this is the value of T C. So apply the equilibrium equation. What you will get? What you will get? You will get vertical component here. Vertical component. It is we know that value of V A and V B. Value of V A and V B in this case will be what? V A and V B. It is W L by 2 due to symmetry. Due to symmetry, we can calculate the value. We can calculate the value. How much is that? 1/2. L is 160. So it is 80/2 means 40 kN. Okay. So the value of V and V B is 40 kN. And this load is 0.5. Okay. And it is acting for which one length? 40. So 0.5 into this one length is, this one length is how much? 80 meter. Okay. 0.5. So V A is 40, V A is 40, and this one component, vertical load, total load will be what? 0.5 into 80. So this component at vertical reaction at point C will be what? It will be VA minus 80 into 0.5. So that component will be 0, 40 minus 40, and equilibrium value of sigma f x equal to 0, you will get the value of Tc as H. And after comparing this value with this equation, what is the conclusion? Conclusion is that as long as we move from this support point A to the central dip, there is continuous drop in the value of tension. The tension value has been decreased continuously, and if we will move further to right support, then the value of tension is going to increase. So the minimum value of tension is H, okay, and that will be at point C. Okay, so H, or you can write, is write as tension at point C. Okay, so in this case, what is the value of H? Value of H is WL square upon 8D. W is known to you, L is known to you, D is known to you, then H can be calculated. Okay, that can be calculated by applying moment at point C equal to 0 for left hand part. What you will get? VA into this distance L by 2, okay, minus this one load UDL, W into L by 2 into L by 4 minus H into this. You will get this expression. So after putting the value, we will get this as 100 kilonewton. Okay, value of H as 100 kilonewton. So the maximum tension, it is under root 40 square plus 100 square, and this value comes to be 108 kilo newton. Okay, and the minimum value is H. Of course, this value is 100. So the first part is completed: minimum and maximum tension in the cable. The next thing is find horizontal and vertical forces in each pair under the following condition. What is the condition? Condition is that if the cable passes over frictionless roller, okay, on the top of the pairs, means at point B, that cable has to be passed with the help of pulley, with the help of pulley here, that will be mounted on the tower. Okay, similar type of thing will be here also. The cable passes through this point. Okay, so in this case we need to find horizontal and vertical forces in this pair, tower. Okay, and in second part, if the cable is firmly clamped to a saddle, okay, in second case, in spite of having this pulley, if we will provide the saddle in this manner, okay, at this point, okay, so this is cable, and okay, this one, okay, this cable, and this will be arranged in this manner, okay, this one. So in spite of pulley, there is a saddle. Saddle has the roller support, that can move at this place. So that we need to calculate next. Okay. So we will consider one by one. So first of all, for frictionless pulley, the cable passes over frictionless rollers on the top of the piers. Okay. So for frictionless pulley. Pulley at top of the cable. So in this case we need to make the free body diagram. At point B, we are making free body diagram at point B. So here is the cable, this is the main cable, and here this is anchor cable. Okay. Here tension is TB. Okay, that we have calculated. Okay, maximum tension. So since it is frictionless, so the value of tension in this, it will also be TB. That value we have calculated, and that calculated value is how much? 108 kilonewton we calculated. Okay, and so this is the arrangement. And one more thing, the angle, this one angle in the question is given. In each case, the back stay is this one cable. Okay, back stay is inclined as 30 degree to the horizontal, means this angle is 30 degree. So this is the free body diagram at point B. With these forces are acting, and with the help of these forces, we need to find the horizontal and vertical forces. So let us resolve the forces. So at this point, this component will be how much? This component will be TB cos 30, and what will be this value? This value is simply h. Okay, and we know this value as 100 kilonewton. Okay, and this one vertical component, it is TB. H will be okay. This one. Okay, so this is TB cos 30. We need to calculate. Okay, it is not h. Actually, h will be this one. Okay, so this one component. Okay, this one component. It is TB. Or if the angle of theta is known to us, calculate kar sakte hain. So this value is h. And the vertical component. This is VA. This will be VA, and this is actually how much? If this is theta, then it is TB sin theta. Okay, this is TB sin theta, and that value is VA, and this one component, TB sin 30 degree. So what is the vertical component? Vertical component is sum of these two. TB sin 30 plus TB sin theta. Sin theta no need to calculate because the horizontal component for this cable, horizontal component, it is nothing but h, and the vertical component, which is acting okay, which is VA and VB and H, okay, at point B, okay, at point B. This was the condition. So the VA, okay. So the V, this one VB, VB is T, okay. If this angle is theta, so this is T, V, this is VA. V is T sine theta, and H is equal to T cos theta. TB actually. TB. So no need to calculate the value of theta. The vertical component is this. Okay. TB we have calculated. So this is calculated. VA is it is 40. And you can calculate the value. We can calculate this value. So the total vertical pressure will be sum of these two. And by putting the value, you can have this as 94 kilonewton. I think it will be 50 kilonewton. The value of TB into sin 30, it will be 54 kilonewton. For the total vertical pressure for this arrangement, it will be 94. Okay. And what will be the value of horizontal thrust? Horizontal thrust will be what will be H? H is known to us as 100 kilonewton, and this value can be calculated by putting 108 into cos 30. So the difference of this will be the horizontal thrust. So the horizontal thrust will be horizontal thrust would be TB cos 30 minus H. Okay, and that value will be minus 6.47 kilo Newton. Okay, minus sign shows that it is acting inside. Okay, it is acting in this direction. So this is the value of the horizontal thrust for case number A. Okay, let us calculate for next case. If the cable is firmly clamped to the saddle. Okay. So in this case, let me erase. So in case of saddle, we have to provide this type of arrangement at the tower. Okay, this one, this is the main cable, this is the position of backstay. Okay, since this value is TB. If I am making the free body diagram at point B, so this is TB. Okay, here what will be the tension in this anchor cable, in this backstay? It will be different. Suppose this value is TS. Okay, this value is different because this point and this point, they are not connected with each other. They are connected with this arrangement. Okay, so this is the free body diagram at point B, and we need to calculate the horizontal and vertical forces as we calculated for case number A. So resolve all the forces. So this one component, it will be VA. Okay, and this one component, it will be H. Mathematically, if you want to write, find the value of theta. This value is TB sin theta, and this is TB cos theta. Okay. Resolve this force, this TS also. In question, it is given that this angle is 30 degree. So resolve this force in vertical and horizontal direction. So this is TS cos 30, and this is TS sin 30. Okay. So with this resolution of forces, what forces are acting in vertical direction, these two forces Va and Ts. So, the vertical forces acting here, they are Va plus Ts, Ts sin 30. Ts is the tension in anchor cable, okay, that you need to calculate, that you need to calculate. So, that can be calculated by equating, by since there is the roller support. So, the value of sigma f x, will be 0, there cannot be any horizontal thrust, okay. So, that is why these two value should be equal. So, the value of T s by equating these two, T s cos 30 is equal to h, we can have the value of T s as h divided by cos 30, and this is how much? 115.5 kilo Newton by putting the value. Okay. So, put this value over here and you will get value of Vs, value of both as 97.8 kilo Newton. So, this is the vertical, and horizontal, what will value will be the horizontal? Horizontal value will be 0 in case of saddle type of arrangement. So, this was the these were the different forces acting on the tower at the top of the cable. Let us do one more question. In this question, a cable is slung between two points at the same level, means we have a cable in this manner with L is equal to how much? L is equal to 120, span is 120 meter, and the central dip as how much? Central dip as 12 meter, D is equal to 12 meter, UDL, it carries a UDL, means W is equal to how much? W is equal to 2 kilonewton per meter. Calculate the change in the horizontal tension. Means we need if the value of H is here, if this point is B, so Vb, horizontal thrust H, Va. So the change in we need to find the change in the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension is this one. Horizontal tension means we need to find the value of delta H. When? Kab? If the temperature rises by 20 degree, if delta T rise in temperature is 20 degree centigrade. Alpha value is given to you. How much? 6 × 10⁻⁶. Okay. Value of alpha is given to you. 6 × 10⁻⁶ per degree Fahrenheit. Okay.
Actually,
if temperature is going to rise, then the length of the cable is going to increase, and with this increase of length, if the length gets increased, then the thrust coming at the support will be lower. Okay. So, in last class, we derived equation del H by H as -3/16 L square by D square alpha into T. That equation we have derived in last class. So, value of del H can be calculated from here, because we know the value of L, we know the value of D, alpha T is known to us, provided we can calculate the value of H. So the value of H can be calculated as H is equal to in this question is only UDL force is acting here. So the value of H as WL square upon 8D. Okay, value of H will be WL square upon 8D. So W is given to you, L is given to you, D is given to you. Then value of H comes to be 300 kilonewton. Okay, so put the value of H, L, D, alpha, T. You can calculate the value of delta H as 0.675 kilonewton. So this is the change in the horizontal reaction. This is the change in the horizontal reaction. Okay. This is the change in the horizontal reaction. Okay. Let us move another question. A cable of span 80 meter. Okay. L is equal to 80 meter. Deep 6 meter. Subjected to rise in temperature T, capital T, 20 degree centigrade. If the coefficient of thermal expansion alpha is given to you, alpha is here 12 into 10 to power minus 6, okay, per degree centigrade, determine the increase in the deep. Okay, here we need to find delta T increase. Okay, as I told you, if the length of the cable increase, then dip will definitely increase. What are the changes in the reaction and the maximum tension? Okay, that we need to calculate. Okay, so value of del H by H is equal to minus del D by D, that we have derived, and that is equals to minus 3 upon 16 L square by D square alpha into T, that we have. Okay. And L D alpha T is known to us, and by putting the value we can have this value as minus 0.008. Okay. Deep D is known to you, therefore del D will have 0.008 multiplied by 6 meter means 0.048 meter plus. Okay, plus sign is there, means it is going to increase. Now what we will calculate, what are the changes in reaction? Find the value of H also. This value of H, WL square upon 8D. So by putting the value, we can have the value of H as 2000. Okay, 2000 kilonewton. Okay, this value will be H. So del H can be calculated as minus 0.008 into H. By put this value and del H, it will be minus 16 kilonewton. So this is the change in the horizontal thrust. Okay, and maximum tension, change in the maximum tension. We know that maximum tension T max is V A square plus H square. Okay, V A is not going to change. V is not going to change at all, only value of H is going to change by 16 kilonewton. So what we need to do here, we need to find the value of T max prior to change, and by H 1 is equal to 2000 kilonewton, find the value of T max. And again find the value of T max by using H 2 is equal to 2000 minus 16. Okay. And find out the change in the tension. And if you will do this thing, then the change tension will be 15.31 kilonewton. That will be the change in the tension. These two books have been used. The question were from book B.C. Pnemia and S.S. Bhavikatti. Thank you for listening.